Fox. And these are my summer host picks, and it would not be summer without ice cream. Think of any of your memories as a child of summer. They all include ice cream, at least for me. And homemade ice cream is the best. But what did it used to take? It used to take, I don't know, rolling around in a coffee can or something and all of that rock salt. This is the easiest, the quickest way to make frozen yogurt, sorbet, ice cream. I'm telling you, it's faster than even going to the grocery store when you're out of ice cream, and it makes the most delicious ice cream. I love coconut milk ice cream. I love sorbet, anything. We've taken $10 off. We put it on three flex so that you can be sure to get it home $16. And here to show you all about the ins and outs, Carrie Mulletta.
Good morning.
Hi. Thank you.
Very nice. I kind of like tried to match you a little bit there.
That's good. I like it. It is my host pick. So, and I pick you.
Thank you.
And I pick Cuisinart. And this has been a huge hit with my kids, of course.
Of course.
They get to pick what goes in it. They get to see it happen.
Absolutely. I'm going to go ahead and just because you're talking, I'm going to go ahead and turn that way.
Oh, yeah. Thanks. Yeah.
So, you know, it's Cuisinart, right? So Cuisinart, we know, makes quality products. And when you start with a quality product, then you know it's just going to be tons of fun. And another thing about this is that they've made it easy. So all of that stuff you were talking about, no rock salt. I actually had someone ask me this morning, do you need to use rock salt with it?
Yeah,
I said, no, absolutely not. All you got to do is plug it in. Now, I'm going to break this down and show you how easy it is to use. Now, what you're going to have is you're going to have your base at the bottom, which is nice, sleek, and small. So you can fit this on any countertop, and I love that. So it's not a huge machine. Also here, you're going to have what is your bowl, your freezing bowl. Now, you'll notice you'll see the frost already on it because you keep this in your freezer. There's a silicone non-toxic material inside, and that's actually what freezes the bowl. So keep that in your freezer for at least 24 hours first time out. Then you've got your mixing paddle, which is a patent design. You place that inside. You're going to go ahead and take the lid. It's an easy lock lid that goes on top, and then it locks right into place. Once it doesn't move anymore, you are ready to go. Now, all you're going to do, this is the hardest part, figuring out what to make. Now, we're going to start simple.
Narrowing it down.
Exactly, because your imagination is to the limit, whatever you can think of. So all we're going to do here is we're going to take what is cream, milk, and sugar, and we've actually added a little bit of vanilla beans in here to actually do a vanilla bean. So I'm going to pour that in.
Oh, let's get rid of that.
And then the hard part really happens. You come to the front of the machine and you turn it on, and it starts spinning.
That's it.
So if you make dinner, you're ready to sit down, and you say, oh, I want to have some fresh ice cream, you know, for dessert. Just go ahead and put your ingredients in, turn it on, and in 20 minutes when you come back, so about the time that you're done eating, your fresh ice cream sorbet or yogurt is ready for you.
Oh, it doesn't get any better than that.
It doesn't.
Really, really doesn't. When I had fun because the kids got to choose whatever flavors they wanted.
Yeah.
And to me, there's nothing better than fresh strawberry ice cream.
So we just made this before the show. So what I just poured in, this is what it's going to come out looking like. So I'm going to go ahead and just, now it makes 1.5 quarts. So you've got plenty for the family. And because I don't always have a lot of time, I try to get the most out of the paddle as I can. And then I'll just have to shush the rest over to the side. But, you know, here's the thing. It's about consistency. It's going to come out like a soft serve yogurt kind of consistency, or soft serve ice cream. And then what you want to do is, if you want to get it extra hard, like for like store-bought, like when you get it, it's like really rock solid.
Yeah.
Then all you're going to do is something like this, what I've done here. You place it in a container, you put it in your freezer, and about an hour or so, it's going to be absolutely like store-bought. So everyone likes it a little bit differently. This is perfect for those root beer float nights. Looky, looky. We do. We just want that nice, refreshing, delicious float, and here it is. So you could do all kinds of different flavors. Mm-hmm. And the thing I love most about something like this, my husband's gluten-free. He also has some dairy issues. Mm-hmm. So when you're looking at getting either lactose-free or you're looking at getting gluten-free, like, because he loves cookies, but he has to have gluten-free cookies. Well, he can have cookies and cream in this because I can put gluten-free cookies inside, and you can't even find that in the store hardly. And if you do, it's ridiculously priced.
Gluten-free cookies and cream ice cream. Even I like coconut milk ice cream, and it's like $8 a pint or something. So all I use is coconut milk in place of the milk.
Yes.
And I'm good to go. Any flavor I want, it pays for itself. Honestly, it's already paid for itself. And you're saving $10 off, so it'll pay for itself even sooner. And you're getting it home on three flats.
Well, look at this. You know,
look at that for the 4th of July.
4th of July. This is time to have a blast with your family, with your kids. Any type of flavors that you enjoy with 1.5 quarts, it's right for a family, so you'll have enough for your setting, and then you'll just put your bowl, again, right back in the freezer, and you're ready to go the next night. Let's talk about maybe doing some different flavors and also mix-ins.
Yeah, and it comes with a recipe book as well. It gives you a lot of different options.
25 different recipes inside and 3 different types of sauces that you can make from scratch. So if you're a person who really wants to make sure you're not getting any preservatives, you want to make sure you're not getting any additives, any things that are chemically based, you know, you can put everything organic. You can put everything that maybe comes straight, you know, fresh. You know what's my fave? Is to do like a lemon basil sorbet. So if you have fresh basil that grows out in your garden, then you can go ahead and put your fresh basil inside as you're doing this. Maybe a fresh lemon.
So now, do you wait until it gets a little bit soft and then you add your mix in?
Correct. So mine's gone a little bit longer, so it's not mixing it as well. So you want to get the mix-ins in right before it hardens up. So I'm going to go ahead and stop this one so we can see. And then the mix-ins are just going to spin right in. So whether you want to do cookies or chips or, oh my gosh, just, but you know, we've done pecans. You can do pecans.
Oh, yeah.
Again, it's all about your imagination. Look at this.
Oh my goodness.
We've done mint chocolate chip. So then we put our chocolate chips in. It could be whatever your fave is. If you want to do chunks, we've done chunks here, so you can do chips. White chocolate, dark chocolate, like you name it. Anything is possible. And here we just put a little green dye because honestly, you know, when you do a creme de menthe or a peppermint's one of my faves. It would be white.
Yeah.
So we did do a little food coloring. You know what's also pretty cool? That there's actually food coloring out there that doesn't have any chemicals in it either. So if you wanted to actually...
Like food-based straight
food. Yeah, food-based food coloring. So again, I love that you can control what you're giving your family. You control what you're giving to yourself. But yet, you're getting all of the absolutely ridiculously delicious flavor. And that's what we're looking for. That's why we go to these really expensive ice cream parlors.
Yeah.
And we go, how about the places that do it by weight? Right?
Yeah.
We go in there, and before you know it, it's $7, and all you did was get maybe like, I don't know, a little bit more than this and a couple toppings.
Yeah.
Do a topping bar at your house. You guys are having a barbecue. Maybe you're having a family over. Do like we've done here and just put all the toppings out. Okay, then everyone comes up and does the favorite. You want to do a little bit of this?
Mm-hmm. Oh, yes.
Go
a little whipped cream.
A little whipped cream. Okay.
Is this my topping bar?
Sure.
Let's go for it.
You go.
We also have some David's cookies out of here because we have a great summer host pick David's cookies. If you want to be able to, like a 1995, we'll pull that up on the bottom as well. Ice cream sandwiches. Look, I'm just going for every single
just
thing
everything.
I have out here because I can.
But think about it. How much would you spend for that if you went to an ice cream parlor?
You know what? I know exactly how much I would spend for it.
Okay.
I went to an ice cream parlor with delicious ice cream. Like the kind that has it has really good fresh ingredients.
Yes.
For 5 of us in our family, $40 for ice cream cones. $40.
Oh, no.
This is $49.95 for all the ice cream my family can eat forever and ever and ever and ever.
Never,
and $16 and ever and ever to get it home.
Oh, I'm going home with the chocolate.
Look at that.
And you know, again, this becomes like a little bit of a meeting place that everyone can kind of do their toppings, do with delicious to them, and it's social. And it's fresh. I can't say that enough.
Mm-hmm.
It really, you do taste the difference. We did our ice cream sandwiches.
Ice cream sandwiches.
Cookie sandwiches for you.
Yes.
Yay. Let's go on down this way. So when you start thinking about other different things you could do, well, we kind of did one of the recipes you were talking about, which
yes,
is the banana chocolate
chunk.
Which
is my favorite recipe.
So we are going to go ahead and throw in our bananas. So I'm just going to do bananas.
It's banana chocolate chunk peanut butter ice cream. That's my favorite.
I heard that and I said, yes.
That sounds delicious.
Ooh, okay. We've been using the peanut butter that we just made out of our dash blender.
We just made from the dash blender, so we're gonna go ahead and put that in, and I'm just gonna go ahead and push it in there, because again, since we can't watch it the way you would at home, sometimes it's gotten to the point where it is pretty much done.
In 20, I'm telling you, 20 minutes, it's
seriously done.
Okay, so sometimes you can even get away with a few minutes earlier. So we're gonna go ahead and stop this guy.
And open her up.
Ready. Here it comes.
Goodness.
Oh my gosh.
Oh my goodness.
Oh my gosh.
Look at this.
Look at all the chunks. Look at all this.
It smells incredible.
You can smell. It's fresh, right? Because you put the ingredients in there. Now, this makes it. I gave a few of these away as a gift. So this is something that.
It's a perfect wedding gift.
Oh, my gosh. People love this. And, you know, the person I gave it to had several grandkids. Her grandkids are like her life. They come over all the time. She wanted something really fun to do with her grandkids. And I said, I've got it. I brought this over. And she just flipped out. And the first day, they were already making, like, different types of flavors. So she always reports back to me and tells me, we made this time. We made that. So someone actually online said, now this is my new one, I gotta try it,
yeah.
Organic lemon yogurt with crystallized ginger is what they made.
That, you know,
so now we go more gourmet.
Right? This because you can actually, whatever your taste buds want, when I want banana, peanut butter, chocolate chip ice cream, and I try to go find it, forget it.
Yeah.
I can't find it.
I
have to go to the brothers, or I guess they weren't brothers, but you know, the guys that charge you $6 for a little teeny pint because they are so creative. You get to create your own flavors. And you get to get it home for $16 and change.
That's great. Look at, I want to eat it right
now. That's the girl after
my
own heart
right
there.
Whipped cream. We need some whipped cream pronto.
We need some whipped cream. That's
yes.
What is missing.
And
yes.
Probably some caramel. I'm going to get caramel, too.
See, you took my recipe. You upped it to the next level because bananas and caramel and chocolate and peanut butter.
Imagine somebody coming over. Look at that. Look at that.
Oh, my goodness.
And you saw us do it. So you saw us. Yeah. There's a place, I'm from South Florida. There's a place, and when you go, you get, you know, stuff like this, and they have names for them, and they're all the different banana splits and stuff like that. These can be close to, like, $15, $20 by the time they add everything in there.
Yeah.
And you're getting a quart and a half of what you're making. So that's crazy. You can make this. Maybe you have your own fresh bananas that you get.
Sorry, we don't have another spoon.
I know, that's okay. You can have it.
Honestly, we could eat into the center of it, and it would be here.
Don't worry. I'll let you have that. You have that. That's yours. Now, say you're having people over, and I was talking about going gourmet, right? Well, here's how you can go gourmet. Sorbets. Sorbets you can do with sugar or without sugar, but what I love about a sorbet is you can use fresh fruits. So if you have a peach tree, if you have, like, this is mango, so, like, from, you know, my mom has mangoes in her yard. So if you have mangoes, if you have just all various types of strawberries maybe that you have access to, this is a great time of year to get some really fresh strawberries. A friend of mine just went strawberry picking. So all that you're going to do is add a sugar or a sugar alternative, and then you're going to go ahead and add the fresh fruit. It doesn't get any more beautiful than this. And then when you're ready, all you're gonna do is serve it in a martini glass right after dinner, a sprig, and look how beautiful that is. And it wasn't hard. Again, all you had to do is put the ingredients inside, wait about 20 minutes, and this is what it comes out to look like. You didn't have to spend a lot of money. You didn't have to go searching for the flavors that you love or the types that you love in the store.
Right.
You didn't have to go to high-end stores to find something like that.
Well, if you wanted to get actual ice cream with real cream and real sugar and real ingredients, you have to pay a premium for that. So think about it right now if you're at home and you're looking at this gastronomical delight. Imagine what flavor you would create. Would you make a sorbet as soon as you get yours home? Are you going to make that vanilla bean ice cream? Are you a purist? Are you a chocolate lover? You just want to load your ice cream up with as much chocolate as you possibly can? You can do that. Do you want that full-fat ice cream? Do you want lower-fat ice cream? Whatever your flavor, you can make that. And you can make a small batch. You can make a big batch. You can make it for your whole family.
Mm-hmm.
You can make it and put it in Ripper Floats. You can make an ice cream sandwich. The sky's the limit, and it's fresh and delicious ingredients that you know exactly what's in it. So for three flats of $16 and change, that's just for this host pick. In fact, that expires at the end of this hour, which is in just, I look around 4 o'clock. It's 2 minutes away. 2 minutes away to get it home for $16 and change. And free shipping and handling.
Frozen yogurt.
Frozen yogurt.
Okay.
Oh my goodness. Oh, it's not free shipping and handling. Whoops.
Oh, yay.
Welcome back, I'm Shannon Fox, and these are my summer host picks, and it would not be summer without ice cream. Think of any of your memories as a child of summer. They all include ice cream, at least for me, and homemade ice cream is the best. But what did it used to take? It used to take, I don't know, rolling around in a coffee can or something and all of that rock salt. This is the easiest, the quickest way to make frozen yogurt, sorbet, ice cream. I'm telling you, it's faster than even going to the grocery store when you're out of ice cream, and it makes the most delicious ice cream. I love coconut milk ice cream. I love sorbet, anything. We've taken $10 off. We put it on three flats so that you can be sure to get it home $16. And here to show you all about the ins and outs, Carrie Mileto.
Good morning.
Hi. I like your summer host pick colors.
Thank you.
Very nice.
I wanted to be. I kind of like tried to match you a little bit there.
That's good. I like it. It is my host pick. So, and I pick you.
I pick you.
And I pick Cuisinart. And
good
this
pick.
Has been a huge hit with my kids, of course.
Because
they get to pick what goes in it. They get to see it happen.
Absolutely.
Kind of magical.
I'm going to go ahead and just, because you're talking, I'm going to go ahead and turn that one off.
Oh, yeah. Thanks.
Yeah. So, you know, it's Cuisinart, right? So Cuisinart, we know, makes quality products. And when you start with a quality product, then you know it's just going to be tons of fun. And another thing about this is that they've made it easy. So always